guys, and welcome back to another episode of Wizard 101 for old folks. Now, I know that a lot of us are new to this game and may not know all the little secrets that we can find in and around the spiral. Wizard 101 has been kind enough to scatter a few freebies and secret areas and secret trainers around for us. So this video is going to be about those areas and those secret items that we can get for free. So y'all, hang in there with me. So first off, we're going to start in Ravenwood. Our very first hidden object that's free is right here in the Myth School. And we are right across from Professor Drake. And if you come up and go to the corner here, there's a portrait of the Lynx Gazer. And it's free. All you have to do is click on it. Now we're at the fairgrounds, and this little trainer standing right in front of me is Sabrina, and she offers some shield spells for your book. Your school should light up and be free for you. So just look on the list and find your school, and it should be free, and you can collect it. Next up, we're over at the pet shop in the shopping center. And if you go right over here, we're going to the side of the desk. You'll see this tiny door, and it's free also. We've made it over to Colossus Boulevard, and we are standing in front of Miss Mindy. Look to her left. You'll see a pathway over here. Take the pathway down. Oh, I almost missed a frost flower. There we go. Never pass up a reagent. You'll need them down the road. And into this little shop we'll go. This is a kind of hidden little shop. Not a lot of people know about it. Of course, the older players do. But if you come into the shop, you'll find a trainer here. And she offers all kinds of different spells for your wizard. If you'll find your school in there, usually you'll find a free spell after you're level 10. So be sure you check this trainer out. Over at the end of Triton Avenue, you'll find the Harvest Lord Tower. Now this one is actually inside the tower, and you may have to do the battle to do it, but you see he's way down here at the end. You have to start way up here at Old Town and work your way all the way across the bridges and all the way down across from the Haunted Cave in order to get to the tower. But after the battle, if you'll look to the left of the door, you'll find a book you can pick up. While you're in the area, go through the Haunted Cave all the way to the end, and after you battle Lord Nightshade, be sure that you look and see if on his desk you might not find a jar of brains. Over in Firecat Alley, you want to find Anna Flamewright's house. Now you will have a quest that sends you over here anyway, not far from the front, but when you find Anna Flamewright's house, go over here to the table and you'll find the pen and inkwell. It's kind of hard to see, but it's that feather that's sticking up out of the table. So you'll want to go ahead and click on that to add it to your inventory. Next up, we're right over the Rainbow Bridge in Grizzleheim at the fort. I have a few things here I would like to show you that you might be interested in. Now, this first one that we're going to talk about is not necessarily free. Just come over the Rainbow Bridge and you're going to stop at this first trader. He has a lot of things to offer, but some of the most important ones that I think anyway, if you're a gardener and you're having the evil magma peas garden and you need this egg basket, sometimes you can't find those at the bazaar. So if you can't, buy the recipe here and you can craft it. Now, another thing that's nice about this particular trainer is that he offers a house that you can also craft. It's the Watchtower Hall. I've already crafted it, and it is a beautiful house, so y'all ought to at least come over and preview it. Now, after you look at him, go on back up towards the front and around the side. And somewhere in this little area between Monstrologist Burke and Snorri, you'll find a half-cut-down tree. And that one's another free item. Now from here, we're going to go ahead and go over the bridge, hang a left, and into Merkholm Keep. Once you're in Merkholm Keep, go to this first teleport stone to the right. You're headed to the Grendel's Grotto. And from here, you want to hug the wall to your left. Just stay on the wall to your left. Go all the way down to the water. Up the water, just stay in the water. And you will... Oops, I had to pick up a cattail. But then you're going to see this statue over here. It's a statue of Grandmother Raven, and it's a pretty statue. And it's now my statue. So we've made our way to Crocotopia, and we've gone in the pyramid over to the Chamber of Fire excavation sites. That's the one to the left that you go to. You want to go down and all the way around to the right. Just hug that wall all the way. Try not to get blocked by the blocks. See the ladder? That's a freebie. Now we're at the Croco Sphinx. You take the boat across, and right across from the tree trainer, you'll find next to the stall a free bowl of tomatoes. I've already picked mine up, but yours will be there. We've traveled to the Well of Spirits and gone to the Karanan Barracks. That's the barracks on the right-hand side. When you get in the barracks, hug the wall to your right. Just travel all the way to the right until you see this doorway. When you go through the doorway, turn to the right, and you'll see this tablet along the wall. This tablet is our next free item. Now back at the oasis, do you see those two tall columns over there? If you look closely, try to get a better view of it, you'll notice that they are lit up. And, oops, sorry guys. And when they light up fully, when the red goes all the way to the top, you can take this teleporter up. And it leads you to a secret shop. You can see we're way up high. Now, it only stays lit up for a little while, ever so often, so you have to watch for it. Then up on this roof, this trainer, if you're in the myth school, will give you free myth spells. Now, I'm not sure if he gives you free spells for each different type of school, but as far as myth goes, they're all free. I believe the other schools, it cost 1 point for each one. But since I happen to be myth, I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to add them to my spellbook. Now we're going to go back down the stairs and head inside the actual shop. inside the shop, you'll see another trainer. Well, he's not really a trainer. He sells items, though. And you can see you have hats or athames that you can buy, and even a croc pet that you could buy, and then a spell deck. We're in the main pyramid in Krakatopia, and up the stairs to the Palace of Fire. Follow the wall all the way around to the right until you find Private Farnsworth. Then, if you look to the right of Private Farnsworth, on the ground, right over here somewhere, here it is a sledgehammer that you can pick up. Now we're in Digimore Station at Marleybone. We've already picked up a rope coil that you can find just around the door. And now, right inside the station, there's this food cart. So pick it up and then just run up a little ways. And there's a set of stairs to your right. In this room, you'll find two different gentlemen. One of them will offer you a few new pets. We've got the wood golem, the cat thug, and the brass golem. They're low-level pets, but if you like the way they look, you can always train them and hatch them with other pets. And this guy has different spells, mostly to take from the minions or add to the minions. Find your school and you should be able to get one for free. We like free spells. Over in Scotland Yard, if you run around behind Officer McGruff, you'll find a picture on the wall here. Now, I've already gotten my picture, but I do want to show you when you get up near the wall, it lights up Officer McGruff's name, so it's very hard to get this picture. It takes a lot of finessing. You just have to keep going back and forth until it's put in the square that it's the picture and not Officer McGruff in order to grab it. While you're in Scotland Yard, take the elevator up to the roof and you'll come down the stairs and to the right, and there's some discarded newspaper you can pick up. And our last stop for this trip is going to be in the Royal Museum. If you go over here towards Counterpoint West, I've already picked up mine, but there should be a photo kind of like this one that's a campsite photo that will allow you to pick it up. Now, like I said, I've already picked mine up, but it should be there for you. So that's going to be it for this video, guys. This is just part one. Now I'm going to get into a part two, and in that one, we'll move on into Mushu and look at Dragon Spire a little bit, and even Celestia and Wisteria too. I know that there's a lot more secret items and trainers out there, so if y'all know of any that I have missed in these worlds, be sure you drop it down below in a comment so that we can all go searching for them. And until I do the next video, I hope y'all have a wonderful time playing Wizard 101. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye, guys!